Another awesome nostalgia build sitting in front of me. This is a kit I have wanted to build since I was a kid. My parents got me the Bigfoot monster truck. That was awesome, but I never had a chance to get the USA-1 truck. And now AMT has re-released it in 1/25th scale. For a long time, all you could get was a 1/32nd snap tight. This is the full glue build one of the Chevy Silverado monster truck. Now, I built this as a Coke truck earlier within the last year, but I was saying during the video, man, I wish they'd re-release the USA-1, and look what they did. They put it out, the actual USA-1 branding and everything. Let's crack open the box. It's got some different things in the Coke edition. First off, the awesome Silverado body. The second best looking Chevy truck. I always like the square bodies, and this generation immediately after them was another favorite of mine. This has got the fenders molded in, the radiator molded in. It is a monster truck, so you really don't have to worry about accuracy or perfection when you build yours. It's got a nice large one-piece frame and underbody. See that? Nice and straight. Everything builds off of this and comes out wonderfully. And I'm going to be doing the whole build and everything. It's not just an unboxing on this one. You can see they've got parts. If you used it as a stock truck, there aren't many stock parts in it. They're mostly monster truck, but it's got a lot of the stock parts like the spare and whatnot. We've got that blown V8. Stock air cleaner. Probably not going to be putting that on. Stock manifolds. Master cylinder. Belt and pulley system with the serpentine. Got our big transfer case and frame braces. Got that nice Chevy interior tub. Got that awesome Chevy dashboard with the additional gauge package. Remember, the radio was always up here, and if you wanted to replace the radio, you had to stick it in this center area instead. It was really weird. Nice bucket seats in there. Got the cut open hood for the blower. Got our tailgate and that perfect Silverado steering wheel. Here we've got a set of white wheels in the white yellowish plastic that you can paint up. See how the one on the box has the white steel wheels with the chrome inserts? Got our wheel backs on here. These are really nice. These just pretty much snap press onto the axles. Got our bumper. Got our roll bar with lights. Got some optional fender flares on the USA-1 that I'm building. You can see there are no real flares on the fenders. They're just a stock bump out. We got the giant leaf spring system. We've got parts of our transfer case, differentials, the big gear. Look at the size of those leaf springs, by the way. The size of these monster trucks is just awesome. We'll get the rest of the parts out here. We've got numerous drive shafts, beautiful set of quad shocks on each corner. Being on the trees like this, so easy to paint and attach them later. They've got very large positive mounting locations, super easy to build and attach later. Got our multiple drive shafts, follow the manual so you know which ones to put where. They're not all used, I don't think. We've got our differentials here. We've got our links, optional brush guard. Now let's switch to the other side of the table, take a look at those parts. We still got more parts to look at. We got our nice one-piece windshield and back glass with open doors. We've got the lenses for the roll bar. We've got a bug shield here. We've got our nice clear red tail lights. Those make the work in the back end a lot easier. We've got a set of four giant monster truck tires. They are lettered so that you know which way to put them on, which side to put them on. But the outward side is just a black wall. There is no brand name. A person could sneak some tire decals on there if they wanted from any other kit. Got that nice roll bar here. We've got a belt and pulley system, some fog lights, nice Chevy grill on there with the headlights and everything molded in. It's real easy to work with that. We'll see. Got our front bumper with winch in it. Got the chrome inserts for the wheels. Got our finned valve covers. Our nice Chevy mirrors off the side. Nice looking chrome tree. That roll bar up top looks great. On this tree, we've got the rest of the chrome roll bar parts. We've got our headers, blower parts. This is a spacer for underneath between the extended bumper and the grill. There's an actual spacer to push it out. That's what that part is. You can see the diamond plate on it. Got our little air cleaners for the blower and different parts for it right there. Also in this one that isn't in the other ones, full chrome wheels. Don't have to put the inserts in. That means you have an extra set of monster truck wheels if you want to use them. Now, the USA-1, I will put a picture of the USA-1 that I remember as a kid, and it had the chrome wheels on it. So right away, we're going to be going with those beauties that are included in this version. And round two, of course, does their awesome decal work. You can see all the older and newer USA-1 logos, all the different things. We got all the different license plates that he uses. Gauges, don't have to paint them in, and all the USA-1 emblems. We got the more modern freedom, the more modern the spirit. America needs the spirit of Christ on there. One Nation Under God logos, those are on the newest version, and you can see it on the box art. He's got them there and there. If you build the older version, they do have just the stripes on there for you. And then, of course, they've got all the newer versions of the USA-1, along with the older ones. We got cab callouts and everything. Beautiful decal sheet by round two. I'm going to start putting mine together, and I'll be right back. Just an hour of simple building. That's how nice these monster truck kits go together. We've got it all ready to head over to the paint shop. We're going to do the links separately, so I can paint them and detail them separately, and then mount them on the chassis later. Everything has such large locating points on the chassis that you can super glue parts together or sand them and model glue them later. Got the master cylinder all together. A lot of the stuff under the hood that we saw, the belts, the pulleys, the fans, some of that stuff isn't, you know, the battery isn't going to be underneath the hood because this is a monster truck, so it's the modified version, and they include all the parts to make a stock-ish Silverado as well. You just have to replace the suspension and driveline. Got the engine and transmission glued together. Now I want to do this all in a metallic color. So I put the intake for the blower and the housing for the pulley system in there with the distributor. That'll all be painted up and hand detailed later. The blower I glued together, I want to paint that a different metallic color than the actual engine block. So I've got that set to go. Same with the carburation. I want to paint those separately. And I want to paint the belt and pulleys. I can do this, I can paint that all, and then just accent the pulleys with a metallic marker and have it come out nicer, that the way I look at it, than trying to hand paint the belt all the way around. It's easier for me to do the pulleys. The drive shafts will be painted up and aligned at another time. Same with those beautiful shocks. We'll make those stand out and look nice like the real one. I got the dash insert glued in. Seats in the dash all the same color, so we'll be putting that in. Same as the interior tub, leave some of the sprue on. We can grip it, prime it, paint it, and get that all done up. Wheel back, same thing. I'm going to be using the chrome wheels, so I'll do up the wheels. Steering wheel and column will be painted black like they are in the Chevys. We've got the body here ready to go. The hood just is off there. We got a little bit of sprue, and this is mostly white plastic, so I probably won't even need to touch it up. We'll cut it off cleanly. You won't even notice, but if you do need to touch it up, just cut it off, spritz a little bit of the paint in a can, and touch it up with a small brush. No one will ever be the wiser. The chrome roll bar, got it all glued together. If you get any smoking or clouding from super glue when you glue these chrome parts together, go ahead, give a couple coats of future floor polish, it'll disappear, you'll never even know. And that's all super glued together and looks lovely. We'll be sitting in the back, so the only work this will need is to have the lenses attached and a coat of floor polish when we do the truck. We'll be all set. The body itself, I did glue the box on. You could leave it separate and paint them separate, but I glued them up to line them up. We'll get this all painted together. I also glued the firewall in. We'll paint it all up like the custom USA-1 truck, which we're lucky the body is all one color aside from decals. The chassis is ready to go. On this one, they want the chassis done in a blackish, or a black, they say. I'm going to be doing it in a black, an off-black, so it's not just all jet black. And the differentials would be in gold on USA-1, so I did not attach them. When I did the Coke build, I did everything together because I did the whole chassis in a metallic red. This one will be doing it in two different colors, and I want to dry brush the chassis. The transfer case will be a metallic color. I'll just go in and hand paint that. It'll give me a reason to crack out the silver on this build. So our differentials look lovely. Large, heavy-duty units. They go together well. You can barely even see the seam, and if you spent time cleaning it up better, you wouldn't see it at all. Nice assembly there, and the wheel, you don't have to worry about painting these ends, so you can clamp onto it, because the entire wheel covers that right up to that lip there. So when you want to paint these, you don't have to worry about any of that. The chassis goes together super nice. Just follow the instructions for which springs go on which side, and you're not going to have a problem. You attach that brace and your transfer case, and that is it. That is that huge monster truck chassis. We'll paint one color, and then I'll dry brush it to accent the details from underneath. I'm going to get everything over into the paint area right now. Come along with.
Thank you.
These monster truck kits are so easy to build, yet end up with a really nice looking model when you're done. They don't look toyish at all. Check out that awesome chassis. I've got all the parts in. The axles are just friction fit in there. They look awesome. Those shocks on there on the box art, they look like they were white with the pistons in them. Then I did the arms and the transfer case and the drive shafts in different metallic shades. And you saw me dry brush that chassis to bring out the detail. So it's a black chassis with an off-black coloration. And then I dry brushed with a pavement and a light gray color mixed in. And we get that nice contrast on all the suspension components and make it look pretty darn tight and cool. And that's going to look awesome underneath that truck sitting up high. It's going to be sitting on that nice wheel and tire package. The one that I liked was the older style from the picture I showed earlier of the chrome wheels. I blackwashed in the very center to give the wheels some depth and then cleaned it out but left that nice chrome rim intact. Sanded those down. Normally I put everything in a drill and sand it, but I don't have any 3/4 inch drive sockets. I'm not a diesel mechanic, so I just used a sanding sponge and went over the whole thing. You can get those at any hardware store. They're literally just a foam sponge covered in sandpaper, and that makes larger surfaces easier. Sanded down the tread, sanded down the side so that it looks like it actually gets used in between shows. We got that nice package there. The interior comes out so nice on these kits. What I'm gonna do is, last time I built a monster truck kit, I said, man, I wish they'd re-release this as the USA-1. Now, I'm gonna make a wish and maybe they'll make it come true for me like they did the USA-1, and I wanna see Bigfoot, and I wanna see the Ford body and the nice interior on those, because the interior on the Chevys is gorgeous. I like them in that red color. I do that red color often. You can see the detailing on there is proud and stands out. We got our shifter in there, cup holders, door panels. I mean, it just all looks great with that Silverado and a little bit of red I put in the center and those dash gauges. When I prime it black, I don't even have to wash inside the vents. It just comes out like that automatically. So that looks excellent, and that snaps into the body with these two tabs in the front and the back. It just drives up and snaps in tight and you're all set. The engine, look at that. That is a big blown motor sitting underneath the hood, ready to go. So I've got that all painted up and detailed, all in metallic like mostly a race engine would be in my mind. That's all set to go and be dropped in. We've got chrome bumper parts for the front bumper. I use the Molotow on the fog lights just so you can see how it doesn't look chrome anymore. It has an accent against it. Did the black for the soft steps on the top of the Chevy bumpers and the rub rails on them. Use that black Sharpie to do that on all of them so that it looks a little more stock. We got the headers. Those will be glued on once the engine is in the chassis. We got the air cleaners. That'll be one of the last things I put on. And we got the mirrors, which will be what I put on just before I do all the decals. The roll bars got the glass in it. Those look awesome. So we'll have those to glue into the bed. And the body itself is ready to go. You can see how that looks when I did the Molotow on just the headlights and not the turn signals. We got to put the Chevy emblem on in the center when we do our decals. Use that Sharpie for the turn signals. The rear turn signals just press in place. We'll be using that nice large Chevy logo across the back, and then detailed when I put the glass in with all the rubber seals and everything. So we are all set to go. The final assembly on these usually goes really slick. If I have any issues, I'd let you know. But when we come back, we'll have the final of USA-1. Yes, 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 Chris is a happy boy. The USA-1 Chevy Silverado monster truck is back in 1/25th scale with the retro USA-1 emblems and the modern emblems if you wanted to update it. I always loved the old school USA-1 when he would go head to head against Bob Chandler and Bigfoot. These were the ones, Ford versus Chevy. These were the big guys on the scene. Some of the first monster truck builders for competitions. TNN, the Nashville network, on Saturdays, watching the monster trucks tear something up at the LA Coliseum or the Pontiac Silverdome. Man, and now I got lucky and I got to build a USA-1 kit, and this kit is out. I'm going to link down in the description, I think, Round 2 for sending it over. Very nice of them. Even though I just built the Coke monster truck for them, they're like, you know, hey, here's the USA-1. You were talking about it. And I built it up. So this is absolutely awesome. I got so lucky in mentioning this that they brought it back out. They give you the option of the chrome wheels or the painted wheels. You can do it up either way you want. I found a glamour shot that we saw in the painting section with the chrome wheels, and that's the way I wanted to do it with that modern Silverado body on there. The interior on these is gorgeous. All the parts fit together so nicely. The chassis keys right into the body. The bumpers just slip into place and lock in with a little bit of super glue. The taillights press in. I mean, even the mirrors, because of their large triangle mount at the bottom of the doors there, those go in nicely. The glass pushes in. The engine goes together. The air cleaners are held on with a friction fit and everything. The grill goes in with a friction fit. That's not glued in. The shocks, the differentials all push in. I've got the shocks glued in so they didn't move, but the differentials just push in with friction. It's a really nicely done kit, and it can come out looking awesome. Now, I don't display a lot of my kits. Most of them get stored. This one's going to be on display waiting to have Bigfoot sitting next to it is what I really, really want. So if anyone at Round 2, if you guys have the license for Bigfoot, if you have the molds, please make me happy before the year is out and release the Bigfoot. And I will put this in the video with it so you can see them side by side. As always, thanks for watching the show. I really love the support from my cool fans, cool sponsors. Build your models for you. You don't have to build a USA-1 out of this. You don't have to build the Coke monster truck. You can put whatever decals you want. Go find your aftermarket decals, your Hostess decals from Round 2, wherever you want, and make your own monster truck as well. Or just give it a custom paint job and use the nice Chevy logos and the emblems on it and build a stockish truck. You can do everything but the axles and the tires. You could retrofit this to another chassis or with some axles and make yourself a stock Chevy. But we're going to hope that they issue Bigfoot. We're going to be able to see that. Maybe someday if they do, it's going to be on the show. Right now, I get to admire my USA-1, which I just love. Thanks for watching the workshop. Build your models for you. Have a great time. We'll see you all at the next review.